Okay, so you were talking about spurs. So let me tell you what spurs are. There are two kinds of spurs. One is vegetative spurs, other ones are known as fruiting spurs. So earlier, which are vegetative spurs, after their vegetative period is over, they convert into fruiting spurs, and then we need some another vegetative spurs, which will be eventually converted into some fruiting spurs. So likewise, the cycle goes on, and the fruiting spurs, they only remain productive up to 1 or 2 years. That means hardly they will give you yield for 1 or 2 times only, because the apple bear only once in a year. So likewise, only two crops can be obtained from a fruiting spur. So like in this picture, you can see that this is the main shoot here, and this could be some secondary branch, and these are the tertiary or could be quaternary branches. And over these branches, you are seeing these small branches here. These are the spurs, and these spurs, they bear two kind of buds, vegetative buds and the fruiting buds. So those spurs which bear vegetative buds, they are known as vegetative spurs, and those which bear fruiting buds, they are known as fruiting spurs. And you can easily identify on the plant itself. See here, you find that many pointed buds are there. So all the pointed buds, they are the vegetative buds, and the round shaped buds here and in this picture, these are the reproductive bud or the fruiting bud, you can say. Just I'm labeling them as V for vegetative bud and R for reproductive bud. And in this zoomed one picture, it is clearly visible that how a vegetative or sorry how a reproductive or a fruiting bud looks like. It looks round in shape, so the dome shape bud is the fruiting bud, and this, the pointed one, they are the vegetative bud. So you see here why we need more spurs, and this is why we need to prune the trees. See, this cycle goes on. So once the spur, vegetative spur, they enter into reproductive phase or the fruiting phase, soon after we need another set of vegetative spur. If they are not there, so after 1 or 2 years, your whole tree will be unproductive or less productive. So that will ultimately affect the yield. And if you are going to prune the whole tree altogether, then eventually in the next year you won't be getting any yield. Because this development of spurs also, see any spur, this vegetative spur also is a 1 year old branch. It is not like that it is only from this bud immediately the branch will grow and you call it spur. No, it is about 1 year old branch, that is a spur. And for 1 or 2 year, there is no fruiting bud on these spurs. They will remain vegetative, and after that they start giving some fruiting buds. So if we are not pruning it very well, I'm not saying that 100% you need to prune the tree. You only prune it up to 50% or in some cases up to 75%. That way the remaining 50% will be productive, and the other branches will be developing the vegetative spurs. Meanwhile, these vegetative spurs will be producing the fruiting spurs. The remaining 50% will be maintaining the vegetative spurs. So likewise, the amount of both spurs is maintained on the trees. So there are spur varieties. In the varieties, you must have gone through some name, spur varieties. So these are the varieties which give rise to these spurs. So they have the higher yield bearing capacity as compared to the regular one or the traditional varieties, because usually 2 to 3 year old, or you say in some cases it is up to 4 year old shoot which give rise to fruiting buds. But here in case, 1 year old shoot and in the second year it can give rise to fruiting buds. So now how you have made this early yield? See, on the regular variety in 4 years you will get the regular yield, but here in the second year or the second year onwards you will get start getting some yield from the tree. That's why I have told you that earlier that there are some methods by which you can start getting yield right from the second year itself. So I think that spur is very much clear to you now, and it is very easily understand. You can easily understand that when you see the tree, you get to know that which is the spur part, which is the secondary branch, which is the tertiary branch. It just because you haven't seen any apple tree, or could be because you belong to some hilly region. So I guess now this is clear what spurs are and why they are very much important, and why so. This is spur varieties are important. So for in case of any query, and if anything is not clear, please try to Google some pictures of spur, then it will become more clear. And if those pictures are not sufficient enough, you can again ask a query. Thank you.